discussing about any thermal expansion. Thermal expansion. See, in general, all substance that expanded on heating. So, which are the substance like solids, solid materials, or liquid materials, and gases also we are expanded by them. In this one, the first we are discussing about the expansion of solids. In expansion of solids, the expansion is less. Compared to liquid and gases. Because of in solid, the all molecules are tightly bonded. That's why it can be expanded is very low compared to liquid and gases. And the solids having particular shape. Now it will be increasing in terms. For example, it is increasing its length. The solid material can be increasing in its length. Is called as the linear expansion. See what we say here, the solids having a particular shape. The shape means there is a the which of the shape there is a circular shape or cubical shape or also plane shape and linear shape, that will be the different of the shape, is it? In terms, for example, in a solid, that material will be increasing its length. It's increasing only for length. It is called as the linear expansion. For example, it is increasing in area. It is called as the areal expansion. It will be increasing its volume. It is called as the volume or cubical expansion. That means the expansion of solids, how many is there here, the types here, there the linear expansion, areal expansion, volume or cubical expansion. It's increasing its length, it is called the linear expansion. It's increasing in area, areal expansion. It's increasing in volume, is nothing but volume or cubical expansion. Volume is nothing but length into breadth into height. Area is nothing but length into breadth. And this is the length into breadth into height, is called as the volume. Now this is the three types of again. Now individually we are discussing about the linear expansion is called as the, see in this one, the first one, what is that? The coefficient of linear expansion. For example, see this will be on the rod. What is taken by this one? Rod. Its initial length, how much is there? L. Now the heat is supplied to this rod, it will be expanded. So length will be expanded. How much is there? Increasing of length is there, delta L. See that is there here. It is defined as the ratio of. Increasing in length of a solid per degree rise of the temperature to its initial length. See, initial length to comparing, its increasing of length, how much is the delta L? See, increasing of length, why to be increasing by this? When we have the temperature can be increasing, that length will be also increasing. Now, it is called, which are the letters denoted by this? The coefficient of linear expansion denoted by the alpha is equal to L2 minus L1. So what is the ratio of increasing in length? L2 minus L1 is nothing but increasing of length per solid. Degree rise in the initial length into temperature T2 minus T1. See here, the L2 minus L1 is equal to also called as the delta L, and T2 minus T1 is equal to called as the delta T. The delta T is nothing but change in temperature. This is called a change in length. Then we can write here the alpha is equal to delta L by L into delta T. Then write here the increasing of length delta L is equal to alpha into L into delta T. See, this is the formula for the increasing of length delta L is equal to alpha. Alpha is nothing but coefficient of linear expansion in initial length into delta T. Write the percentage change in length. Percentage change in length. The percentage change in length, this L is taken this side. Delta L by L into 100% is equal to alpha into delta T into 100%. See, this is the formula for the coefficient of linear expansion. The next after that is there coefficient. The second one is there coefficient. Coefficient of areal expansion. Area expansion. It is denoted by letter is the beta. Which letter is denoted by beta? The again the same definition. See the which are the definition of the, is there the linear expansion? The same definition is there here the same. But here the length, here what is the area? It is defined as the ratio of the ratio of increasing in area. Increasing in area of solid for degree rise of temperature. For degree rise of temperature to its initial area. Then we can write formula. Beta is equal to A2 minus A1. The change in area by initial area A1 into change in temperature. Increasing of temperature T2 minus T1. Now here also write A2 minus A1 is nothing but to delta A, the change in its area, and T2 minus T1 is equal to delta T. The substitute here the beta is equal to delta A by A into delta T. Now the cross one here, the increasing in area delta A is equal to beta A into delta T. This is the formula for here the increasing of area. Therefore, the percentage change in area, the percentage, the change in its area, that means A is taken this side, delta A by A into 100% is equal to beta into delta T into 100%. Now this is the one. Next, the last one is there. What is there? Coefficient. Coefficient of cubical or volume expansion is denoted by name gamma. Is denoted by name gamma. It is also now just it is defined as the ratio of increasing its volume. Increasing its volume for a solid. The degree rise in temperature to initial volume is denoted by gamma is equal to V2 minus V1 by V1 into T2 minus T1. The similar we can write the gamma is equal to delta V by V into delta T. Now we can write the increasing of its value delta V is equal to gamma into V into delta T. This is the formula for the increasing of its value. Now write the percentage. Therefore, the percentage change in volume. The percentage change in its volume. Delta V by V into 100. Delta V by V into 100 is equal to gamma into delta T into 100. So this is the formula of a coefficient of linear expansion and coefficient of areal expansion and coefficient of cubical or volume expansion. See the next we discussing the topic is the relation between alpha, beta and gamma. Alpha is equal to coefficient of linear expansion and coefficient of areal expansion, the coefficient of cubical expansion. But this alpha is equal, is there alpha? And beta is equal to 2 alpha and gamma is equal to 3 alpha because of here wall is length, here the area is equal length into bed, and here the length into breadth into height, that is a 3R. Then write in the ratio alpha is to beta is to gamma is equal to 1 is to 2 is to 3. See the next topic, the variation of density of a substance with temperature. The substance, the density is equal, what is the formula is it? Density is equal to, is given by D is equal to mass by volume. Mass by volume. See, denoted by the V. Now we can write the mass is equal to, mass is equal to M is equal to density D into volume. But here the mass will be constant. Say that D1 V1 is equal to D2 into V2. D1 V1 is equal to D2 into V2. Here according to cubical expansion. See, what is the formula of the cubical expansion? Gamma is equal to V2 minus V1 by V1 into T2 minus T1. This is the formula for here. Now we can write here the V1 is equal to, take the cross multiplication, then V2 value can substitute here. V2 value can substitute here. We can write the formula for here. The gamma is equal to together, gamma into V1 T2 minus T1 is equal to V2 minus V1. The minus V1 is taken. Gamma is equal to V1 T2 minus T1 plus V1 is equal to V2. And V1 will take the common, then V2 is equal to V1 into gamma into T2 minus T1 plus 1. This is the formula. This V2 value can substitute, and the finally we are getting this variation of density gamma is equal to D1 minus D2 D1 minus D2 by D1 D2 into T2 minus T1. What is the variation of the density of the substance? Gamma. Gamma is nothing but cubical expansion. Gamma is equal to D1 minus T2 by D2 into T2 minus T1. D1 initial density and D2 is the after rest. This is the formula for the variation of density of substance with temperature. So next topic, the difference in length independent of temperature. Let us consider, this is the two rods having different length. See, this is considered the L1 and this is considered the L2. Now heat is supplied to this two different rods. Now it is increasing, that is a variation of length L2 minus L1. Now heat is supplied and now we are increasing, now is there. Now the first length is L1 rod and second length of the rod is L2. Now it will be increasing and it is also increasing. Now the increasing of length, the first rod is delta L1 is equal to delta L2. Since we know the increasing of length, delta L is equal to, what is the formula is here? Alpha into L into delta T. Alpha into L into delta T. This is the formula we can apply. Delta L1, delta L1 is equal to alpha into alpha 1. Because of its increasing of coefficient of linear expansion is alpha 1. The second rod of increasing of coefficient of linear expansion is alpha 2. Say the L1, alpha 1 L1 into delta T is equal to alpha 2 L2 into delta T. See, delta T is gets cancelled. Alpha 1 L1 is equal to alpha 2 into L2. Now it's taken, L2 is taken this side and alpha 1 is taken this side. L1 by L2 is equal to alpha 2 by alpha 1. See here, there is no depends on of the temperature, because of in this formula here is not the temperature. That's why we say the independent of temperature of difference length. So next we're discussing about the application of expansion of solids. See what is the application of expansion of solid. The first one we discussing about the bimetallic strip. Bimetallic strip. The first one we discussing about the bimetallic. The bimetallic strip is nothing but the we are considering the two metals. See this is the first metal rod and this consider the second metal. The first metal rod made of a brass. The second metal rod is made of a steel. Now heated together, that means the temperature applied to this the bimetallic strip. Then when heat is applied to this system, now the brass can be expanded more than steel. The brass is expanded more than steel. That means it is the inverted. This is the reaction. This will be. See the first one is there the brass, the upper is there the brass, and lower will be there the steel. And which is the more expansion is there? The brass rod can be more expansion, the steel can be the less expansion. This is considered the coefficient of linear expansion of the brass is considered the alpha 1, and the coefficient of the expansion of the steel rod is considered the n 2. And this will be the two. The which is the more is there? The brass. Can be expand of the more because of the absorbing of the heat is the more and steel is the less, that is the less expansion is there. See when we are heating, this is the more expansion, this is the less expansion. Then this strip of the radius will be decreasing. That radius of the bimetallic strip R is equal d by density by alpha 1 minus alpha 2 into delta t. See this is of a radius of a strip. Radius of a strip. That R is equal to, what is the formula? R is equal to d by alpha 1 minus alpha 2 into delta t. Now the second application. Variation of time period of pendulum clock okay due to expansion thermal expansion. See this is the second application. See what is the variation of time period of the pendulum clock? That due to thermal expansion. See, let us see, we are concerned. This is a rigid support. Now, the suspended by a thread is nothing but wire. It's a lower position. Its lower position we can attach it by the bar. Lower position we can attach it by the bar. Now, here this is called point is the suspension of position. The suspension of position to the center of the bar is called as the length of the pendulum. Is called as the length of the pendulum. See, this time period of a pendulum, t is equal to 2 pi into under root of l by g. What is the formula? Is it the time period of the pendulum, t is equal to 2 pi into under root of l by g. The t is directly proportional to the square root of the length. See, when the length will be increasing, the time period also will be increasing. The length will be decreasing, the time period also will be decreasing. See, here are two conditions. In summer, the temperature is increases. The temperature increases means the pendulum of the length will be also increasing. Length is also increases. See here the center of the bob and suspension length. See when the length will be increasing, the time period also increases. Therefore, time period also increases. Time period also increases because of it's directly proportional to the temperature. In summer, because of the temperature will be increasing, the length of the pendulum also will be increasing. the length of the pendulum increasing means the same time the time period also will be increasing, but actual time is loss of its, the clock is loss its time, clock is loss its time because of this take the more than the initial to compare. అంటే ఇక్కడ కంపేర్ చేస్తే ఇక్కడ కంపేర్ అవుతుంది మనకు ఆసిలేషన్ చేయడానికి ఎక్కువ టైం తీసుకుంటుంది. అంటే ఎక్కువ టైం అంటే లెంత్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అయిన కొద్ది ఆసిలేషన్ చేయడానికి, నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆసిలేషన్ చేయడానికి మన టైం కూడా ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది. కాబట్టి ఏమవుతుంది, ద క్లాక్ ఇస్ లాస్ ఇస్ టైం. అంటే ఇక్కడ చేసే కంటే ఇక్కడ ఏమవుతుంది మనకు ఎక్కువ టైం తీసుకున్నది, ఇట్స్ ద లాస్ ఈస్ ద టైం.